This is a preparation video for the IB Business Management course. After the videos, please click www.imtmace.com on the link at the bottom of this video to try out our assignments. Unit 4.1. The role of marketing. Marketing is essential to the success of any business. Marketing is not just about selling or advertising, as many people think. It is more of a business philosophy of how best to think about satisfying consumer needs or demands. There are many globally acceptable definitions of marketing. Some common ones include the following. Marketing is the management process involved in identifying, anticipating and satisfying consumer needs profitably. By the Chartered Institute of Marketing, Finance and the Marketing. Since marketing costs money, the marketing and finance department have to work together in setting the appropriate budgets. The marketing department may want to spend more than is in its budget to meet the requirements of a demanding marketing plan, but the finance department may advise that it sticks to its given budgetary allocations. This will cause departmental conflict. Human resource management, HRM, and marketing. Marketing information can enable more effective workforce planning in an department. This can influence the demand and supply of labor in an organization. Ensuring that the right quality of salespeople are hired, those with innovative minds and a competitive spirit, will also aid in meeting the marketing department's objectives. Operations management and marketing. The production and marketing departments will need to work together to ensure that the products developed meet the specifications of the customers. Market research will help the marketers in determining the needs and wants of the consumers. Both departments need to balance the time needed to test, develop, and launch products, to avoid any loss in sales or reputation and any arousal of potential stakeholder conflict. The marketing of goods and services. In deciding how to market their products, businesses first need to distinguish between goods, such as cars, and services, such as insurance. This is because goods and services differ in a number of ways. Differences between goods and services. Goods are tangible, can be touched, can be returned if you did not like what you bought. Can be stored and consumed later, for example, yogurt. There is ownership of the product. Goods are easier to compare because of the similar nature of some products. For example, one TV can easily be compared to another. Services are intangible and cannot be touched, cannot be taken back, for example, a bad haircut. Cannot be stored and will need to be consumed immediately. For example, your consultant's time. There is no ownership of the product. Services are more difficult to compare because of different experiences a customer may get from a given service. For example, a hotel may treat a customer differently each time he or she visits. The marketing of goods is based on the 4 P's of the marketing mix, namely price, product, promotion, place. The marketing of services includes the 3 additional aspects of people, processes, and physical evidence. Market orientation versus product orientation. Product-oriented approach. Inward-looking and focused on making the product first and then trying to sell it. Product-led and assuming that supply creates its own demand, says Law. Here business produce innovative products and tempt the customers to buy them. Market-oriented approach. Outward-looking and focused on carrying out market research first and then making products that can sell. Market-led and focused on establishing consumer demand so as to supply products that meet consumers' needs and wants. The benefits to a business of being market-orientated. Firms have increased confidence that their products will sell, therefore reducing the risk of failure. firms can respond more quickly to changes in the market and are also able to anticipate market changes. Firms will be in a strong position to meet the challenge of new competitors entering the market as a result of regular feedback from consumers brought about by market research. Market orientation does have some limitations. Conducting market research can be costly and therefore weigh heavily on a firm's budget. Due to frequently changing consumer tastes, firms may find it difficult to meet every consumer's needs with its available resources. Uncertainty about the future could also have a negative influence on market planning strategy. A product-oriented business will have these advantages. It is associated with the production of high-quality products such as luxury sports cars and safety products such as crash helmets. It can succeed in industries where the speed of change is slow and the firm has already built a good reputation. It has control over its activities, with a strong belief. The major limitations such a firm faces include the following. Since the firm ignores the needs of the market, it takes risks that may lead to eventual business failure or closure. Spending money on research and development without considering consumer needs could be costly and not yield any promising results. You may now try out the free assignments. All assignments will be marked and feedback will be given immediately. Email us at administration@intmace.com.